feel the tournament anglers are ready to try their best to capture some magic on the legendary Tennessee River fishery known as Guntersville Lake.
It's Tennessee River, man. They're so healthy.
Look at that hammer.
And while a few get off to a hot start, the cold weather has everyone fishing slow, hoping for that big bite.
What do you think about that?
It's the 2017 FLW Tour season opener on Guntersville Lake, presented by Lowrance. Hey everyone, Travis Moran here alongside Byron Velvick, and we're bringing you FLW Tour action. We've got a lot of great sticks on tour this season, including some fresh young blood. We've got 30 rookies joining us that are gonna be throwing their first cast from the front of the boat this week. How exciting is that?
You know, it's really exciting. It's exciting to see 30 guys that take the big step and the preparation, the mindset to go into the big leagues, fish this tour event and stepping up against the pros. It's exciting because not just are these 30 guys taking that leap of faith and making a career with FLW, it also shows you how many guys are stepping into this sport. We got a full field of 165 boats with 30 rookies stepping in, and those 30 guys have to be pumped to be fishing in the big leagues.
But these veterans are not gonna step aside easy.
No.
This lake is fishing tough right now. Lake Guntersville is part of the Tennessee River chain of lakes and is probably one of the most pressured lakes in the entire country, with tournaments being held every single weekend. The reason being, there's plentiful grass, which really sparks up tons of bass. And then let's not forget about the bridges. That's where the magic can happen, and that's what happened day one for Jay Kendrick.
Jay Kendrick goes out and throws a swim bait around bridges. I love swim baits on Guntersville. Who doesn't? Swim baits catch big fish, lots of big fish. I've spent a lot of time on that lake throwing those baits, and now Jay Kendrick has won a lot of tournaments out there throwing it. He is a local raker, a legend, if you will, among guys in that area for throwing swim baits, and he went out the first day and just had a field day. And to that point, he thought it was all game on, and it probably took a lot of other anglers and convinced them to go throw a swim bait too. But with swim baits, you know, you go from hero to zero, it's feast and it's famine, and day two, things changed dramatically. It got cold, the swim bait bite just evaporated like it does so often because it's so fragile, and it got down to the slow bark rows and those guys that were willing to commit to that grass that we talked about and throw those crawfish imitating baits, the crawdad crankbaits, lipless crankbaits and otherwise, and just really dissect the grass real slowly. And that was a game changer, major game changer for Lake Guntersville.
As we get ready to head out on the water, let's take a look at the top 20 leaderboard and just see how many sticks are actually still in contention.
And take a look at this. You got Mark Rose and Brian Thrift. Mark Rose, he's unbelievable on the Tennessee River. He knows this river system so well. He's won a lot of tournaments up and down this river system. This is water very familiar to him. And he's got to feel great and just at home, be able to fish his style of fishing. Nice, slow, methodical, and to the converse of that, you have Brian Thrift, who's burning the water up usually. A man on fire that you can't keep up with, but watch Brian Thrift, he's even slowing down this time. Even he's milking these spots. It's a real testament to how stingy Lake Guntersville is fishing this week.
Absolutely, and then we go down to number four, Justin Atkins. Guntersville shook 29 of those rookies loose, but we still have Justin Atkins, the only rookie on our top 20 here, still in the hunt. And so I'm really looking forward to seeing how this one plays out over the rest of this weekend. And then jumping all the way down to ninth place, Andy Morgan. No surprise here, the 2016 FLW Tour Angler of the Year. He's always going to be the hunt. You can count him in on any kind of tournament on any lake.
Especially when it's a shallow bite. You know, it's a shallow bite, and he's right there. We even have Shin Fukai coming in, and he's catching them. And as we look at these guys, all of these guys, we're seeing that shallow bite just unbelievable shallow bite developing better and better all over.
The fish are still in a winter pattern. I'm targeting a certain type of grass called eelgrass, and it creates a good current break. And I'm fishing on the backside of a river bar, and I found a place where they're tucked in out of that current to it's just a place that they winter. And I'm catching them just cranking a crankbait that runs a certain depth or stay right over the top of the grass.
I've had a little deal figured out and kind of understand what the fish are doing a little bit. I have. Now, this cold night last night, man, it got down in the 20s, so that's really going to affect things, and but I'm just going to be real optimistic, and a lot of stuff I hadn't looked at yet and hadn't fished, and I'm real excited about day three.
We're in the lead. Let's go try to maintain it.
most important for the that kind of lipless crankbait need to angle. Yeah. They just don't bite, so we just need to bait front of the fish. So I just casting over and over. Same area, but different angle, different. Sometimes I change the bait, then sometimes different sound. So yeah, that's important for the lipless crankbait. Different angle. Oh, that's strong. Yeah. Woo! Dang. He showed, but it's almost 4 pounds. See? Look, he's berry. How berry, right? Number one in the boat.
This is just one of the main causeways on Lake Guntersville. There's a popular bridge right back behind us, but they don't seem to be on the bridge, you know, real good right now. So I came here in practice and figured out that there was just a ton of big old gizzards going down this bank. I about couldn't even get a bait down through it without catching one. So that just told me that, you know, if the bridge isn't real good right now, that maybe they're up and down this causeway feeding on all this bait. So, you know, I've been doing this a long time, and you're gonna have some highs, and you're gonna be in that zone some, and then sometimes you're gonna be dead last, and you're gonna be everywhere in between. So you just kinda gotta stay the course, stay focused, and know that you're gonna have some bad tournaments. I mean, you're gonna finish the entire, you know, place of the field. So you just kinda gotta roll with it, you know, and know that you did your best every tournament, learn from your mistakes, and then those highs will come around. And Dan Moorhead said it best one time. He said, a pro fisherman is all about staying broke as long as you can until you get rich. And that's pretty much fishing.
Good way to get it going.
Mark Rose and Brian Thrift, been there, done that. These guys are sitting 1 and 2, and they feel, I would say, very comfortable sitting in the 1 and 2 position. They're not putting that undue pressure on themselves because this is something that they've been there before. Yep. You know, Mark Rose and Brian Thrift, they may lead this thing all the way through because of their experience and because they just know how to react and how to act in that slot.
You know, this is the first tournament of the year, so to get off started on a good foot and get a good check to start the year off, you know, I mean, that's everything. That gets the ball rolling for the rest of the year. You can carry that momentum forward and have a good season just by getting your confidence in the first tournament.
Something these anglers have been talking about is these fish biting real finicky. A lot of times they're just slapping at it. Anglers are talking about slack getting knocked in their line but not hooking up. And that's because these fish are really not fully committing to these baits. It's been an ongoing theme throughout all the anglers of barely hooking these fish.
That's a good start. Chunky fat.
The fastest moving man on a tour, fishing as slow as I've ever seen him.
Got one.
The FLW Tour is brought to you by General Tire, anywhere is possible. BRP Evinrude, learn more at evinrude.com. You can get more from your oil with Quaker State. Costa Del Mar, see what's out there. Ranger Boats, still building legends, one at a time. And by PowerPole, swift, silent, secure.
That's the way to start.
We're getting some bites, we're gonna catch some today.
Not a bad one for number one.
The ones here just aren't biting, so I'm gonna move in a little shallower. I had 8.4 here during practice.
Yes.
Mm.
Not a big one, but it's number one for sure.
Number one, first stop on the FLW 2017 Tour at Guntersville, brought to you by Lowrance. If you look at our leaderboard, we've got Thrift and Rose as the one and two guys, and that's experience. They know what to do. They know those changes to make.
When you're in that fourth, fifth, sixth, eighth position, you got a little bit more room to breathe. Guntersville has a ton of big fish in it. You are not out of this thing if you're in 12th or 15th place at all.
Right.
There's a ton of 6 and 8 pounders out there.
Number one and two, they got the target on their back. That's what everybody that's, you know, from 3rd to 20th place, that's what they're shooting for today and tomorrow. And so I guess that 5th spot, you can really just sneak in and relax, and you're within striking distance, but you just don't have that pressure you're talking
all
about.
All those places, all those guys, you know, that's the best part of being in the hunt, but being just a little bit out of it. Give me a couple good ones, and I'm gonna be hunting for day 4. I'm gonna be the strong guy going into day 4.
This is my first tournament as a professional on the FLW Tour. This is the tournament that really scared me. I was concerned about this one. I've had a lot of tough experiences here in February, and I just put my time in.
Big one. Yeah, a big one too.
Last year, I had a big team event here and caught one bass, and I stayed the night, got an extra room, went back out there the next day just to try to learn more about it. So I've put a lot of time on this lake, just getting ready for a moment like this, and it looks like it's gonna pay off.
First tournament right out the gates, went on the road.
Make it look easy.
And boom, he's in the top five, hanging out with the top studs on tour here, and definitely carrying his weight.
Here's what we're seeing a lot of. The crawfish pattern is dominating. A lot of guys came in here thinking swim baits. I mean, swim baits, gizzard shad. I would have been there throwing swim baits. I would have been right there. And then the first day to see Kendrick crush them and lead the tournament, I promise you, day 2, a lot of guys got detoured off to that. But that's not been the case. We're seeing a lot of guys fishing the crawfish patterns, whether it's the red, the browns, the oranges, the yellows. It's a natural reaction in bass to go out and feed heavily on crawfish, especially the females, prior to the spawn. Key number 2, fishing shallow. Well, we've seen the guys, and they're all fishing shallow. Even if they're way, way, way off the bank, they're talking about how they're fishing shallow. They're fishing a sandbar. They're fishing some eelgrass. And so Morgan, Cobb, Rose, Thrift, I'm seeing all of those guys out there fishing very, very shallow. And shallow fishing is the key. And then the third one is gonna be fishing slow. I mean, just slowing down. The water's cold. You gotta fish thorough. You gotta fish slow. You gotta realize that the fish are slowing down. They're having to pop those baits off of the grass, then keep retrieving it. They're moving baits, they're fishing moving baits, but they're staying in an area, they're fan casting the whole area and really working through that. So those are the 3 things I've seen develop as of this morning. Those are the things I'm seeing.
Look at how he's got these black spots on him. That's just a typical cold water bass, but especially in this Tennessee River, man, they're so healthy.
He sounds like he's nice and even keeled, which is good to see from a guy, you know, that young and on a rookie. And so I now even feel more strongly that he is a guy that could be fishing tomorrow and could be have a chance for that first win of the FLW Tour. Yeah. We're going to Mark Rose right now.
And look at that bait he's throwing. A little crawdad, you know, a little more yellow, but crawdad pattern crankbaits, you know, it's just something, and the watercolor complements that so well. You look at that watercolor at Guntersville right now, you know, those colored baits like that are such a nice contrast to that brownish, greenish water that you see right now in early spring Guntersville.
Well, I ran onto a little dry spell, ran over to another little section that I hadn't fished, but I've been noticing it. Man, fishing is such a mental game. You can go dry for a little while, and it can get you down. Fish. The fishing is just tough. It looks like I'm really whacking on them, but you know, I'm scratching and clawing to catch what I'm catching, and I'm just fishing everything in that creek that I feel like fish would be staging. I know where they're going, so I'm just trying to back off and fish where I feel like. Now I am getting up there real shallow. If the sun comes out and I feel like the water's warming up in certain areas, I am going up there shallow, but mostly I'm just trying to picture an area, look at an area where I know all these fish are going to the bank, and I'm trying to get in the little mouths of the creeks and in the ditches and things like that, transition areas, and trying to figure out where they'd be staging.
Man, this fish got me feeling good right now with what this fish is doing.
Look at that hammer.
We had two solid days of practice with sunshine and with a south wind. And then we go into the first day of the tournament, we got a north wind, we got cloud cover. Those fish just, you know, as they moved, I was fortunate to move with them. But what made it so difficult is when you're in practice and you set up on these places for a south wind, you're having to turn right around and learn all over again during the tournament when you get a direct, you know, swap. I just got through talking to one rookie that's here this year that had a pretty decent practice and everything. But that wind change, he stayed with the big line, fished all around me during the tournament, and he asked me, he goes, dude, what was you doing different? And when I explained what I was doing, dong, a light went on. And that's how those guys learn, that's how I learned, but that's what it's all about, it's fishing.
One of the guys using these smaller baits, these crawdad imitations, is Shin Fukai.
Taking that lipless bait, you can see him right here, he's actually looking for that grass, finds the grass, pops it off the grass, and so many of your strikes come right when you pull that thing off the grass and you make that pop and you get that deflection, that very natural deflection of a crawfish coming off the bottom, hitting a piece of grass, and then resuming its cadence and, you know, looking to settle back down to the bottom. And that's when the bass will capitalize on it and crush that crawfish imitation.
Yep, might be a good one.
This is working better than a lot of the other deals because we've had the bad weather, we've had the front, it got colder. The crawfish bite is still the most stable bite out there. It's a smaller bait, it's not like a swim bait, you're not swinging for the fences. The crawfish are still active, even in the cold. These bass are lethargic, but they're just not gonna miss an opportunity to get themselves another crawdad, especially like that. Look, we're seeing a lot of pre-spawn, big females, big healthy bellies on them. And again, that belly is driven by the nutrients that come in those crawfish.
Absolutely. It really looks like Shin's got the hot hand right now. He just seems relaxed. He seems like he's laughing out there. And even though everyone else is bundled up cold, he seems like he's just got that momentum going right now. And we're obviously watching him move up the leaderboard.
What place did he start off in this morning?
He started the morning in fifth.
Yep. Yeah, so that's what's nice. You know, you're in the hunt, but you're not at the top. When you're in that fourth, fifth, sixth, eighth position, you got a little bit more room to breathe.
You don't have very many opportunities, especially on a day like today.
We're back.
And we are watching Lake Guntersville, first tour stop of the FLW season 2017 unfold. If there was ever a bluebird sky, no wind, post-front situation, this is it.
Mm-hmm.
And those are tough days. By this time of day, you're calling 6-pounders. You are calling 5 and 6-pounders and these chunks, but this is shaping up to be a completely different day. The weather has thrown these guys for a curveball. You know, the gizzard shad bite is out, the swim bait bite is gone. We're seeing guys that are fishing slow, fishing crawfish pattern baits, and it's a different creature out there on Guntersville today.
Yep, go from third to 20th.
You get it around noon and you're not getting bit. So, you know, your mind's going 100 miles an hour. Do I change baits? Do I throw the same bait? Do I throw a different color? Have they moved shallow? Have they moved back deep? All this is going through my mind and I'm trying to think of what I need to do. And even though I can look at my graph and I can see these fish positioned there, I kept telling myself they're just not biting where I'm at. They're just not biting.
Still got plenty of time. I mean, 5 cast and you can have 5 in the live well. First day I caught my whole limit in basically 30 minutes. So I had two in the live well, but I ended up culling out those two.
You know, the water's cold, but the water's warming up. It started off this morning at 45, and then one area that I was in, it was up to 52 by 1 o'clock. That's the way it was yesterday. So I was thinking, you know, the fish should be biting, but it just wasn't happening for me today.
Catch the little ones.
This is just a little staging area, a little pre-spawn area. They go back in here is really good, but this is just a perfect, I mean, these little rocky points, and there's a gut coming up through here, and it just, that's just where they, you know, hang out.
Not gonna be a keeper, I'm afraid.
Is there a certain point that he may take a break from trying to catch those big fish? to just trying to fill out this limit so that he makes sure he doesn't leave anything out on the table coming into weigh-in here?
You might be seeing that right now. I mean, look, he's put down that crankbait. He's gone to what looks like, it's obviously a different area, a little eddy break kind of rock thing. He's fishing more of like a worm jig situation here. Maybe this is a place he went and shook some fish off in practice, so this is like a little meat market where you can go there and feel like you can catch a couple keepers.
Because he pulled right to this spot. This is more fish he's caught all day. I mean, this is crazy. This is crazy.
It's a nursery. Look at this. It's a nursery. They're all small.
What in the world is going on?
The more little ones you catch, the more you start wondering if there's even a keeper in the bunch.
These little bitty guys.
Just question how long he's actually going to be doing that for.
Yeah, I'm getting bit every cast, but can I pull a 15-inch bass out of this spot?
This is the decision right now. This is a moment right now that he's got to figure out. Is he going to weed through these to get a limit to where, potentially, if he gets a limit out of here, the least it's going to be is, you know, add 3 more pounds to his total, which is
it's a cushion.
Could be huge.
It's a cushion. It's an insurance policy not to leave one hanging, not to leave a fish, not to come in with 4 in the well, you know?
Yep, yep.
He's zipping it on in, but look right there. It's just a little bit. We'll call that the babysitter.
Yes.
He's at Nursery Island, and he caught the babysitter at Nursery Island. So that's the one that was keeping guard off for all the little babies. So he has now captured the babysitter. You wonder if there's another babysitter, if this is actually like a preschool.
Yep.
And there's a babysitter and a teacher's assistant.
There he is.
Yeah.
All those sighs. Remember we were hearing all those sighs when he was here catching these little fish after little fish.
And look what he's doing now. This is an important. This is definitely his cull fish. He's caught a 3. He's caught a 4. He's caught a 5. That little fish, he hopes, will not be riding around for the rest of the day.
And he's fishing for a win.
I think we're going to be leaving Mark Rose right now and check on unofficially second place Brian Thrift. Brian Thrift said he hopes he has enough just to stay in the top 10. Has no idea he's doing nearly as well as he is. Unofficially, he has a couple 3s, the rest are 2s. I'm sure he doesn't feel great about it because, again, he knows he's on Guntersville, but he's actually doing very well for a very tough day.
To win this tournament, it would be awesome, you know? I mean, anytime you can put a $125,000 check in your pocket, you can't complain about that at all. And plus, it pretty much makes your year. I mean, you hit the lump sum at the first tournament of the year, you know, so you can kind of breeze through the rest of the year and rest easy knowing you've already made your house payments and all that, so you're good to go.
Number 5 is in the box.
All right, here we go. A 5-ounce limit for Andy Morgan worth 15 pounds, 6 ounces. Brandon Cobb, 18 pounds and 5 ounces for Shin Fu Kai. 16 pounds and 11 ounces, biggest stringer of the day. 20 pounds and 2 ounces for Alex Davis.
Well, I've thought about that big check on the home lake ever since it was announced at ICAST. That's all I've thought about, so I'm going to try to make it happen tomorrow.
17 pounds, 14 ounces, Scott Suggs. A 5-bass limit for Brian Thrift. 17 pounds, 4 ounces.
Now here, anything can happen. You know, you catch a 7 or 8 pounder and get 4 good 3.5 to 4 pounders to go with it, you got a shot. So I think anybody in the top 10 still got a shot. I mean, there's a 30-pound bag out there.
Mark Rose, new leader, 19 pounds even. He breaks the 60-pound mark.
I look out across this crowd and I see a bunch of guys that fish, you know, bass tournaments around here. This lake just got so much history, and I enjoy doing good on a lake like this, and hopefully we can pull this thing out tomorrow, Chris.
The General Tire Pro Team angler Mark Rose regains his lead with 61 pounds and 8 ounces. Top 10 pros will crown a champion, $125,000 on the line.
Hello everyone, Travis Moran here with Byron Velvick. Day 4, stop 1 on the 2017 FLW Tour, Lake Guntersville, brought to you by Lowrance. And we have a great tournament going on right now. Some huge names in the top 10. We started with 165, gotten down to 10 anglers.
I'm gonna switch it up a bit and go shallow first thing, see if I can't catch
a big one or two big ones or even three big ones, and then I'll just go do my game plan out there on the river and hope we have five big ones to catch Mark Rose today.
I got to catch a giant bag to win. I feel like I'm going to need at least mid-20s to have a shot to beat Mark. And I'm going to go out there and fish as hard as I can and fish some new stuff and mix it up and see if we can get a couple big bites today.
We got the lead, and I'm not one of these guys that say, man, I'd rather be right there in second and putting all the pressure on first, because in fishing, you need every ounce, every pound you can get, and I'll take all of it.
Mark Rose, day three leader going into day four.
Yeah.
He's really having a great tournament.
Mark Rose is absolutely doing what he's known to do, which is just get on him, figure him out, catch him. And boy, when he's out there and he's dialed in, he is so tough to beat. He's such a great angler. Very well known, respected, loved on the tour. He got a hold of that leaderboard on the second day, and he's been going right after it. But here's kind of a funny side story. Ryan Thrift right behind him. I mean, this is like shades of 2014. Sam Rayburn.
Sam Rayburn.
2014, kind of the same bite. And Mark Rose, Brian Thrift right there, real close to each other, you know, basically swapping punches at this point. Keeper for a keeper, large big one for a big one, and it is super, super tight. And again, it's Guntersville. So there's so many big fish in the lake, anything could happen on this final day.
Gonna try to catch some.
Here it is, one of my first stops this morning. I just gotta keep plugging away. Stick to my guns. I'm gonna do what got me here. I'm gonna do it all day long, and hopefully at the end of the day it pans out.
I'm on a deal that I feel like the whole tournament has been based on sunshine, and here I am. I'll wake up to this right here, heavy cloud cover, not knowing what to expect. When the sun's out, I'm able to catch these fish all through the day. I don't know, you know, I just never know when I'm gonna catch the next one, because it's pulling these fish up. And for the way I'm fishing with a rattle trap and this shallow grass, sun's just better right now with a little bit of wind. So what's gonna happen today? Who knows, but I'm not gonna change a thing, because I'm where I'm at right now. By throwing my rattle trap, I'm gonna continue through this whole tournament.
Woo! Woo! What a way to start!
Suggs is one dangerous guy to be going into on the final day, because he knows how to close. He's the closer. He's a good closer too. Guy knows how to catch them big time.
That's the way to start.
In this top 10, we have a lot of guys that are familiar and comfortable with winning tournaments. Another guy that is local, he's kind of the hometown favorite right now, Alex Davis, a guide out here.
We kind of had a gloomy day today, so I figured a shallow bite might work. So I kind of did something that I haven't done all week, and I went and threw a Jackal TN70 and other rattle baits shallow.
First one.
Mm-hmm. Come to daddy. It's a notorious spawning big bay or creek arm. It's not really a creek, it's just a humongous bay to me. And where I was fishing, they kind of have to swim by you. So I was just fishing a point. It's just a shoal point, and it has grass rimmed around it. It's just a good staging place.
Not a bad one for number one. They need to grow up real big if I'm gonna catch old Mark Rose today. But
it's almost no surprise to see these guys taking red lipless crankbaits out of the fish's mouth, is it? Or a crankbait. Boy, I'll tell you what, it's such a crawfish pattern deal.
This morning, it's a race, man. We got the top 10, and they're showing up to play. And right off the bat, Mark's fishing very similar to yesterday. He works down a bank a while until he sees some good structure.
I'm not worrying too much about the tournament right now. I'm focusing on what these fish are doing, what I need to do to catch them. I'm going to stay the course today. It's gotten me here. It's gotten me almost a 5-pound lead. So today's not a day to be going out and trying a bunch of Mickey Mouse goofy stuff. I may change areas, but I'm sticking with the same pattern. I feel like I understand what's going on in some of these areas of the lake, and I'm just going to stay with that gut feeling. And this isn't the first time we've seen some clouds in the past couple of weeks, and the temperature is about the same. Water temperature should be about the same. So. I'm gonna stay the course. Fish number one, the hardest one to get right there.
This one's short and fast. He's a keeper.
I think he'll measure.
Not as big as they've been doing, but I'm glad to have him.
Number one, first stop on the FLW 2017 Tour at Guntersville, brought to you by Lowrance.
With our day four coverage with Mark Rose right now.
He is looking, hunting, pecking, praying for number five. He's got four in the well, and it is past 11 o'clock.
I got two threes and two twos.
This is that moment where he's like, man, don't let me call in on the final day with four fish. And you know these guys are all so close and the weights are so tight. You don't have a runaway deal going on here.
We got the two leaders, Mark Rose on the left, Brian Thrift on the right. Now he's sitting on four fish right now. I think once these guys hit their limit, it may be an open ball game now. Because you know, it's the second Thrift gets a limit and he decides that he's probably cashed out on this spot and he starts running around, that's when he might stumble onto some of these big, big Guntersville sacks.
I feel like the only chance I have to win is to catch a 25 pound bag or bigger. And right now we've got about 10 pounds. But I'll take it, it's better than nothing.
Making the final day, it opens a lot of doors. You've only got 10 anglers on the water, it frees up a lot of water. And the fish haven't been pressured as much as they have the first 2 days of the tournament. So you can run around and fish stuff you haven't fished in the tournament or in practice and kind of get one of those random lucky bites. And I don't know, the way my mind works, I feel like I've always got a chance.
We got five. Yay for us. They don't weigh much, but we got five.
I was fishing little shallow water, but I'm going catching, I want to catch a big one, so I'm trying to little deeper stuff. I'm still looking for a big fish. I already got three fish right now. The weight is maybe 8 pounds so far, so I'm looking for the two good one right now. We got sunny day yesterday, then today the all cloud, I mean, it's cloudy day, so it's gonna be different. It should be good, but... Good one. Yup, that's big.
He's just getting more and more dialed in. Yep. Yeah, that's amazing to watch that happen.
But he's talking about running up that river too. More dialed in, but at the same time keeps talking about gambling, you know, gambling. Caught big ones up the river. When do you hold them, and when do you fold them?
Giant, but it's almost 4 pounds. I'm 4 pound egg.
This place we're fishing right here is actually just a shallow bar next to the river channel, and it has a gradual slope. It's not one of those ones that just drops straight off. It gradually slopes out here. It's got hydrilla and eelgrass that grows on it, so I'm trying to just pump that rattle bait. Try to get it stuck and then try to pop it free, and it seems like they'll hit it as it's actually falling like a jig.
Alex won back on Guntersville. He won a Costa event in 2012, so he's no stranger to fish these FLW events. This is his first shot at FLW Tour event on Guntersville, and we're going to see how that shakes out.
There's number four. Took forever and a day.
And here he is, man. And this is Mark Rose having to figure this out, because he right now is in this position of wondering, what is it going to take for me to put number five in the box and try to get these guys off my back? The wolves, as he calls them. He says, I always feel like I'm being chased by wolves in these tournaments. And that is his way of trying to fire himself up. He's got to feel the breath of them on his neck at this point. They are nipping at his heels.
Oh,
gosh.
Believe he's gonna make it. Thank the Lord. Ain't much, man, but I'm gonna tell you what, I have worked hard for that fish right there.
FLW Tour is brought to you by celebrating 60 years of fish finding excellence, Lowrance. GoPro, this is your life. Be a hero. The world leader in off-road innovation, Polaris Off-Road Vehicles. Yeti, built for the wild. And by TH Marine, from transom to trolling motor.
Three even?
Man, what a grind.
Not quite.
Oh, God. Oh, God.
We are here at Lake Guntersville, stop number one on the FLW 2017 Tour at Lake Guntersville, brought to you by Lowrance.
Brian Thrift is now unofficially the leader of this event. 211 is his smallest fish.
This is just a fisticuffs. These guys are just throwing the punches out right now. They have no idea what the other guys are doing.
The weights are so tight, so I can't wait to see how this thing goes down.
Now Suggs, he's fishing that main lake, that open water.
Suggs likes to sit in an area though, man. Once he realizes there's fish, he's a guy that's really good, and we talk about that a lot. Where you have Brian Thrift, who's a run and gun guy that likes to just burn up water. Suggs is notorious for really just settling into an area and milking it. He'll spend a whole day on an area if he thinks it potentially, and do well with it. Makes minor adjustments, move off a little bit, but stay in an area and really grind through it.
I was fishing rattle trap on a lot lighter line than people are normally used to fishing a rattle trap on, especially in heavy grass and stuff. I was throwing it on 12-pound line, and I was throwing a Berkeley War Pig, and I'm only throwing a half ounce, but I'm taking the bait and I'm having to throw it out there, count it down, and the fish basically wanted the bait crawling. I mean, you had to be reeling it slow, and when you'd come to the grass, just a little quick pop with the rod, and usually that was the reaction, you know, that it took to get you that bite, and that's how I fished it all week.
I popped it a certain way, and it felt like it either ran into a fish or a fish swatted at it, but didn't try to eat it. I turn around, make the same cast, he eats it. So that's the main thing about fishing. When you feel like, sometimes you'll go, man, I think that was a bite. Most of the time, if you think it was, it was.
Suggs has been very consistent through this event, but eventually he's gonna have to try to look for that bigger fish.
Right.
He's gonna have to, if he wants to take over the lead, he's eventually gonna have to get closer to that 20-pound mark to really make up some ground. He's just a statue right now. Like Mark just switched up some stuff here.
He is a Tennessee River expert. But right now, Guntersville has been very stingy to him today.
Nobody's jumped out and stuck some big fish in this lake as I'm capable of producing.
Oh, please, let me get you. Oh.
He's not that much better, but he's a little better.
Lake Guntersville had a not a 10 pound, but I think lots of 6-8 pound in this lake, so everybody have a chance to catch a big one. If I go 2 6-pounder, I still have a chance to win.
It's a giant. Yeah. Dang! Woo!
Watch your macros. I'm behind you.
Hey. I like Shin. Yay.
Shin is, he is in that place you want to be in where it's like, just let me take a shot. I can always strike you guys from behind. I can be that secret person coming up and just getting it.
Yes.
Brian Thrift is on the move. Got tired of looking at his area, said he wanted to make a run.
If Brian starts running around and run gunning, he may end up getting some huge fish going.
I'd been eyeing this one little deal off to the side of where I'd been fishing. Went over there and start throwing a little square bill around it. And I see this giant just come out from under the dock and eat the crankbait right beside the boat. It's a good one. There we go. That'll help the cause. That would definitely help the cause.
Look at this. Now that is a Lake Guntersville cull, to be sure. But to a little square bill,
That's a big fish.
That's a beautiful
That's
fish right there.
That's a good one.
That may be his best fish of the day right there. He's got a couple really good fish.
Yeah, boy. Time on the water's almost up here at the 2017 FLW Tour opener on Lake Guntersville.
It sure is, Travis, and everyone's hoping for some last minute heroics, and they're casting until the very last second. Alex Davis knows it can happen at any moment here on Guntersville.
I kept thinking it's gonna happen. And I mean, all day I just kept fishing places that big ones live, and I just, until I actually had to lift my troll motor to come in, I thought it was gonna happen, which is a really good feeling. I mean, I love this lake. It's got big ones. I just love a place that has big ones.
Yes! Woo! Goodness gracious, that took forever.
At the end of the day, I'm about to go to the area where I've caught a lot of my big ones. And man, I don't have much time. Gosh, I've got like 5 minutes to fish this area. Not even that, really. I feel like I got enough time to make about 5 or 6 casts.
Oh, please, Lord, let me get this.
Every rooster, every eagle, every buzzard, they came crashing out of the trees. I screamed so loud.
Wow, talk about a clutch fish at the right time. That is a huge bass.
Travis, that is huge. I mean, what a cull right there. We're talking a 3, possibly 4 pound swing in his total catch. That could be the deciding factor at this weight.
Woo! I may get beat, but that fish gave me that feeling of victory.
All right, we've got 10 guys to weigh in. Are you guys ready to get this thing started? 13 pounds, 7 ounces, moves you to second place. 16 pounds and 15 ounces. He is coming after you, Shin Fukai. Number 5 in the bag, 16 pounds, 14 ounces. You got him by 5 ounces, the rock star Alex Davis. 18 pounds and 4 ounces, 72 pounds and 10 ounces. You are the new leader.
From Shelby, North Carolina, Brian Thrift.
To dethrone Alex Davis, you needed 15 pounds and 14 ounces. If you got one that weighs like less than a pound, you're gonna take the lead. But you need number 5. Wow! 22 pounds even, 78 pounds and 12 ounces.
Number 5, baby. Woo!
Yeah! Here's what it comes down to, man. It is Mark Rose versus Brian Thrift. A 5 bass limit for Mark Rose. 17 pounds and 4 ounces is what you need for the win. 5 today worth 18 pounds, 3 ounces. Your champion is Mark Rose. $125,000 richer. He catches 18 pounds and 3 ounces on the final day.
Well, I knew I had found one little special area. I just had that gut feeling. You know, nobody even tried to come within a mile of that thing. And I knew right then when I set my boat down and nobody found these fish that that it was gonna be a special tournament. I didn't know that I'd be sitting right here, but I knew that it was gonna be special. Anytime Brian Thrift's in the top 10, it's gonna be close. My hat's off to him. He's just an unbelievable fisherman. You know, he makes you go out and perform your best. I tell you, Team Rose Outdoors is here today. They all came up here to watch, and we're a team. Faith Family Fishing.
Mark Rose getting it done on day four, over 18 pounds.
Mark Rose barely squeaking out by Brian Thrift for the win.
What a last minute catch to actually put him at the top of the leaderboard and let him take home the trophy.
Amazing first event for the 2017 FLW Tour season here at Lake Guntersville.
Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.